Latita, honey, I'm home. I don't smell nothing cooking, so somebody got a lot of splitting to do.
So today we are doing a special edition of Bonding with Bird mukbang style. So we are at Mardi Gras Tuesdays here in California, and we are going to try all these things, but we're actually going to play for charity.
What is a mukbang?
It's not an election. So all of these items that we have in front of us, we have some shrimp mac and cheese, and we also got some beignets. And of course, you can't start a debate without a, what do you call this thing? What do you call this?
I don't know.
A firecracker.
Multicolored drink. It's like a popsicle thing.
Yeah, that part. So with the mukbang, we're gonna eat, we're gonna enjoy food, because you know I love food, babe. But there's gonna be a point for every little thing. So if you eat a fry, or you eat, if you eat a fry or some hush puppies, those are gonna be counted as 1 point. If you eat any shrimp or any oysters, that's gonna count as 2 points. If you eat any fish, it's gonna be 4 points. And if you have lobster or crab, that's gonna be counted as 3 points. And the more you eat, the more money you get. We are playing for $500, and it's gonna go to our best charity. Well, the charity of our choice.
Okay. Sounds like fun.
So let's get at it.
One.
The hush puppy. Okay, I'm gonna do oyster. Two. I eat two fries at once, huh? All right. So can we please talk about this last debate bullshit? So Trump didn't even want to have a debate together with Mike Pence. I mean, with Biden. So they did everything separate. So Trump was actually on NBC, and Biden was on ABC. But Trump was on NBC, MSNBC.
CNBC.
Right. So he was on IO, right? And and I think he had like 14 million viewers, the Biden, and Trump still had like less. He had like, Biden had more. But let's talk about the main things, the moderators. Moderators didn't even, honestly, they were actually better this time because they had control. But I'm sorry, one thing that actually made me feel good was the fact that Biden was talking about the, was it in 1994? Biden was talking about the crime bill in 1994,
uh-huh.
And the moderator said, "Are you actually, like, are you okay with how that went down?" Basically, and he was like, "No, he actually regrets that,"
right.
Which I appreciate, because technically you should regret it. It was something that was horrible, you know what I mean? And it wasn't really in favor of the people, especially people of color.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But
listen, every now and then, somebody has to admit that they made a mistake. Unlike a certain guy who shall remain nameless, who can't admit to making any mistakes. And by the way, with this shrimp, I now have 5 points.
Well,
because I'm the best eater.
You didn't see how many french fries I just gobbled down, but you know, that's something different.
Yeah. Luckily, we got somebody out there keeping count. But
But voting is so important. You actually went down to, we went out together and we actually took our ballots in and we put it in. But can we track it? We can track it.
Oh, actually we're able to keep track of where our ballot goes and at what point in the process it is. But I'll tell you what's disheartening.
What?
I'm pissed at Trump for a lot of things, but the thing that I'm probably most pissed at him about is he has made the electoral process so suspect that when we went to drop off our ballots, I didn't feel comfortable. We went like to three different places and I didn't feel comfortable at any of them, you know, and finally I picked a place that I thought, you know, was pretty heavily populated, where, you know, somebody might notice somebody trying to steal ballots or going in there at the wrong time or whatever.
Right.
But it shouldn't be like that. I should be able to cast my ballot and have it count, you know?
On American Idol, they cast votes all the time. You could do it by text. You could, like, I don't understand. What's the difference? Why can't we vote by text? Or why can't, like, I'm just confused at the whole situation.
Because then somebody might think that AT&T and Sprint and T-Mobile is in it, okay, with the Russians. In SARS, being an acronym for Special Anti-Robbery Squad, which is a special unit that they have in Nigeria. And these guys have been doing all kinds of, abductions, rapes. Violence against people in Nigeria. And one of the things that I heard is that the people over in Nigeria are, they're kind of pissed that, in particular, a few celebrities.
Of Queen Bee.
But Beyonce. But, and, you know, particularly because, you know, she did that album with all the, you know, African stars on there and you know using their music and stuff like that. But they're like, hey, you know, you should say something about this. You know, you should say something about the violence and the police brutality that's going on here in Nigeria.
Do you think celebrities should actually speak up about these topics, especially when they're using their they should use their platform? You think that?
Well, you know me. I believe that if you have a platform and if you step to the mic, you should say something, you know, and not just it shouldn't just be, oh well, you know, I sympathize with you, or yeah, you know, we can all rise up together and be wonderful together. Well, you know, if we ignore the least of the people who are among us, how does that make us any better than the people who subject us to injustices every day? You know. Listen, the bottom line is if you see something wrong, you gotta speak on it. You know. The saying goes, it's not the voice of our or the loudness of our enemies, it's the silence of our friends. But that's just me.
So let's talk about our celebrity rundown. Matthew McConaughey.
Hey, I like Matthew.
Yes, I love him. As a matter of fact, this is some quirky news. So he has a book that's out right now. His book is called Greenlight, right? And in the book, he's talking about how his father died. This is some weird stuff. So his father died having sex with their mom. So when he climaxed, he had a heart attack. But he always said that he wanted to go out that way. He said if he was going to go out any other way, he was going to go out climax.
You know, listen, you come and you go.
Literally.
Hey.
Just wanted to
swat
you.
What's with the flies around here? Like, God.
Okay.
I love this place, but the flies.
Ah, flies. Okay, so Jesse Williams has to pay $40,000 in child support. So we were always talking about child support, right? Child support, spouse support, all same thing. So if you think about that, per month, $40,000, what is that? About $500,000 a year?
Yeah, somewhere around
there. That's a lot of money. And he has to pay back support too. What do you think about that?
Well,
I feel like I already know what you're going to say.
Well, here's the deal. If you were given a child support order and you fall short of that child support order, you owe that money. But I think the bigger question here is, how much money is enough money for child support? Mm-hmm. Okay. You know, yeah, I mean, you know, your child doesn't have a separate residence or, you know, a car, you know.
But does a child need that much money?
I don't know if a child needs that much money. It depends on where he lives. I mean, if the child lives in Bel Air, okay.
$40,000.
If the child lives in Bel Air, okay, you gotta understand, when it comes to child support, everything is factored in. Where you,
all right. Go ahead.
Where you live, what kind of neighborhood you're in, if you go to private school, how much it costs for private school, if you have nannies or whatever the case may be. You know, judges kind of look at, well, what is the lifestyle to which you've grown accustomed?
Right.
Okay. That's how they figure that in.
Right.
And let's say the mother never worked, right? Let's say she never had a job the entire time she was taking care of the kids. Well, yep. All of a sudden now she's cut off from that. And you know, you got to figure that into how much the other spouse makes. Mm-hmm. Okay? You know, so they don't do this haphazardly. There's a calculation that goes into how you come to a figure every month. And all things are factored in. Gas, electric, water,
heat. A lot of money.
Yeah. Hey.
$40,000.
Listen, if that's the type of lifestyle you're used to, let's say he was spending $100,000 a month to maintain his family. $100,000 a month, that's $1.2 million a year, right?
Okay.
Well, half of that is $600,000. Right?
Okay.
And in this case, that $600,000 is what she would be entitled to. At least half. And if you have the kids, come on.
That's true.
There you go.
That's true.
Look, we got three kids. That's four of us over here, and you over there playing around and doing what you want to with your money. Nope, you play,
you
pay.
It's fair.
Yeah, that's the way I look at it.
That's true.
But
speaking of, I mean, Cardi B and Offset, you know, she filed for a divorce and everything, and I heard that they are basically reconciling, and Offset just purchased her a $335,000, what is it, Rolls Royce truck or something like that, and a $10,000 baby stroller, what do you call that thing, backseat thing,
car seat.
Yeah, $10,000 for that.
There's no such thing.
$10,000. Yes,
there's no
there
such
is.
Thing.
My question,
what, does it come with a chauffeur?
I need y'all to comment down below, and I need y'all to tell me.
Yeah, yeah, y'all comment down below. Chauffeur.
How much money does somebody need to offer you to get back with them?
Cheaper to keep her.
So, did you hear about the story about Jeannie Mai talking about that she wants to be Jeannie Mai? She's the talk show host on The Real. So she is engaged to the rapper Jeezy, and she.
I didn't even know that Jesus had.
Jeezy.
Oh.
Jeezy.
Like Jay-Z.
So yeah, so she said that she actually, when she gets married, she wants to be submissive to Jeezy. So, the question, why are you laughing?
I don't know, man.
Well,
Because it would have come out better if you had said she was submissive to Jesus. But Jeezy? Okay. Gee whiz.
Yes, so she wants to be submissive to Jeezy. Mm-hmm. And I understand where she's coming from when it comes to the whole thing.
Okay.
Because it's one of those things where, think about it. Oh, we didn't even try the beignet. Okay, it don't matter. We'll try that after. But I think I ate the most. Look at everything that I have on my plate. You don't even have anything on your plate. I don't see no shells.
No, you know why I don't have anything on my plate? Because I ate.
Wait, no, but there's shells.
Hold on for a second. I can prove I ate more.
Okay.
Because I got somebody. I got. Well, here, little fella.
I think this money goes to me.
Here.
I think this goes to me.
Here.
It really goes to me now. I'm $500. Go to my charity joy.
Hey. Thanks for watching this special edition of Bonding with Bird. On behalf of Kamalu and myself, we just want to say
like and subscribe.